So an all-unseeded Malaysian affair then for the women's doubles final. You're in the company of Paul Hand and Gail Enns. Great to have you along.
And on my left,
don't go anywhere.
Lim Yin Lu, Yap Cheng Weng, Malaysia. Yap Cheng Weng serves to Manila Vista City. Oh, play. One love.
Our team in blue have the luxury of having a lefty on board, which is always helpful. We saw that in the mixed doubles, didn't we, with Reddy and Chopra. Teal, the youngster, really stepping up, the 19-year-old. She's alongside Anseli, who's the 28-year-old, who's well, former top 20 player. Anseli there. The back of your picture on the left.
Go!
Service over. 3-1.
Go!
4-1.
Nervous start, really, from all four players, I'd say.
Yeah, it's never nice playing against your teammates and. Friendship does go out the window.
Makes for a good watch, Gail, doesn't it? Because they know each other's game so well. They kind of can almost preempt what's to come. So that kind of gives them a read on the play that little bit earlier. And makes for long rallies. Very engaging.
Yeah, it can go two ways. Sometimes when I've played against English pairs in finals, and it's can be a very bad game because you know each other's game so well. You're reading each other. Yeah. It can get a little bit
predictable.
I was going to say tense and tetchy as well, and it just doesn't. It's not nice viewing either because you know people are so nervous. And but then you can have the other way because you know each other's game so well. You can have incredible rallies and really put on a show for people. Very, very good shot from Lim. This forehand shot, defense shot, it's not just about driving hard, it's about putting it right in the corner with real crisp, short action from that racket.
Well, it's a strong scoreboard lead. For the marginal underdogs, there's just 10 ranking spots between these two teams. These two in your picture are ranked at, what are they, 76th in the world, and their opponents 86th, so not a lot between them.
And their rankings will be lower than what this really, realistically, they would be. I'd put these two pairs probably in the top 30. It's just obviously new partnerships are still trying to climb up that world rankings.
So we're 8-2.
You can see what the badminton Malaysia are thinking. Just split the stronger pair up, blood them with the youngsters, and bring on their experience as a consequence. Nothing like going through the fire together to give the younger player wealth of experience. All the communication, all the tactical nous here from Anseli in the ear of Teo.
Four, eight.
When you've got an older player and a younger player combination, it can be very easy for the younger player to duck and stay out of the game. But what the older player has got to do, it's not their job to take over. They've got to nurture that person. So it's all about encouraging and making sure you work as a team. That's the best way you learn. And also you're going to win. You cannot win a match on your own.
Good leave from the experienced Lim, the left-hander. So it's a 6-point game at the moment with Lin and Yap ahead, heading to the mid-game interval. And breathe a little easier, you'd imagine, with that lead. And you'd imagine it would allow them to be just a little bit more expansive as well when they resume.
11-4.
Nervous return there from Teo. Spilt well wide, so it is the Lim and Yap with the advantage, quite significant, 7 points at the moment.
Yeah, you can see Lim really talking to her partner there as well. She's the one, the older player, she's really making sure that Yap, she doesn't want to lose, she wants to win this, but she needs Yap to be on the same page. She's there encouraging her, motivating her, so like, keep going. I've been very impressed with Lim and Yap, actually. I think they're aggression, I think their feistiness straight from the start. They were, yes, yes, in the face of their opponents. It can seem a little bit, unsportsmanlike, especially when it's your compatriots, your teammates. But this is how you're going to win matches. You have to turn off everything that, you know, your friends and your best mates off court. When you're on court, your opponents. And I've liked that those two in particular, Lim and Yap, have been doing that right from the start.
Yep. Yep. Confident smash, kill there from Yap. And interesting as well, in mid-game interval, the coach that they probably share on their travels is elected to stay well out of the way, respectfully, because, of course, he doesn't want to give one team advice and not the other.
No, you can't do that. It's it's just etiquette as well. And if you've got to, sometimes it's good for a coach to not coach. You allow the players to think for themselves. They're in this situation. It's a final. There's nothing wrong with letting a player work it out for themselves.
Hey. Seven, 5-12.
Well, they've got a lot of work to do, these two. 7 points adrift still. Rise to the challenge.
Yeah, Tio's struggling a little bit here.
She's the same, girl.
Just not moving very well. That was a static defense shot. She wasn't ready in the ready position. Her legs were straight. You see her body language. She's just talking to herself. There's no fire there yet.
And it's tricky for Ansley as well, because she will want to intervene, you'd imagine, in desperation and sort of almost overpress in doing so. Well done. There's a good, timely intervention from Ansley, getting involved.
And that's all she can do. When your partner's a little bit nervous and a little bit inexperienced, there's not much you can do. You can't control somebody. You can't tell them what to do. But what you can do is lead by example. You can be the one say, look, let's just go for it. Be positive. Take our chances.
Well done. That'll buoy the confidence a little more.
7-14.
Leave from Lim. Now, you'd imagine it would be at this kind of stage that they kind of almost let go of the first game a little bit and almost get ready for the second and throw caution to the wind. Just go for it now.
Yeah, it's broken a string, so that's why the two girls are really hitting all their smashes on her. She was doing very well with some of those defense shots. She was getting that shuttle as far, she was hitting it as hard as she could off those hard smashes, but eventually there was no tension left in her racket, and she could only lift that shuttle half court, and then, of course...
Look how hard she was swinging there, just
she
to try and clear
so
the net.
Well. She should have just blocked, run in and let her partner take over, but I think she was desperately trying to get that into the back of the court. Maybe she could have run off, grabbed
run
another racket.
Quality rally, arguably the best of the match so far. Really good to watch.
9-15.
Blues so frugal in error, giving nothing away and trying to keep on the attack, but denied there. Good play from the orange and black duo.
Turning slightly men's doubles. Everyone's just hitting it really hard. There's lots of drives, lots of power on the smashes. I mean, what both pairs need to do is just that ability to use the net. No one's doing the soft touches, finding the gaps. It, I guess, is a little bit of a...
flat hard drive.
Yeah, and a bit of a status. Right, I'm going to hit it harder than you. It's great for us to watch, but tactics-wise, it'd be good to see who can create those gaps on court.
Hesitancy there. Decided to leave it, then play it. Lim, who's been so committed throughout, just a slight bit of dithering on this occasion. Gap reducing now on the scoreboard.
Brilliant smash. That is world class. For someone so young to create that power, 11. And she's a small girl as well, so she's got that disguise. And here, to create that angle from her height is very, very impressive. That left-handed disguise, cross court.
Service over. 12-17.
So the more senior, advanced in age player would serve. Good patterns of play there. Backing up the serve
13,
well did
17.
Tia. wonderful variety from Lim and Yap there.
Service over.
Very, very clever shot from Yap. She's done all that hard work. 13. She managed to work herself around the back of the court, moved well. And then I'm not sure how much she meant this shot. I'm gonna say that she did, because she was slightly off balance, but she managed to keep that control and did this very, very good flat punch clear straight into the backhand corner.
Service over, 14-18. Yes.
And those are the soft shots we were talking about. It's that ability to not to hit that. It's so tempting to hit that shuttle really, really hard. And Tio was just clever enough just to hit that into the space. Mm.
Spreading the court well.
Yeah.
Well,
the comeback is on in the opener. Suddenly it's got a different complexion about it. These two with a nice sense of calm, typically Malaysian in their style.
Service over, 19-16.
In these arenas, when you've got big airspace, the shuttle fluffs up very, very quickly. So as the rally goes on, it's important to push up the court, because you need that extra oomph from your racket to get that shuttle over the net. And just there, Anseli, she was still too far back on her defense, and she wanted to play the cross-court block. She didn't put enough on that shuttle.
She had enough on that one, didn't she? She redeemed herself there.
Yeah.
17-19.
Spike on that smash, straight at Lim.
That's why you often see the players change the shuttle so much. They want the crisp, crisp new shuttles.
Service ball called. Service over.
Oh, that's untimely. And it's brought up three game point opportunities then for Lim and Yap here. They've beavered so hard to get back into this game, but yeah. A swing and a miss, and the game is secured by the marginal underdogs. Lim and Yap take the opener, 21-17, just 19 minutes played.
Lim Yin Lo, Yap Cheng Beng, 21-17.
I think that it was an interesting game of ladies doubles. I thought that towards the end, both pairs had decided that maybe we should start using the net shots more. And you saw a little bit more variety rather than just mid-court, bash, bash, bash. I was very impressed with Lim and Yap to start with, but then those doubts just crept in. And that was not good to see. There was Lim, she left a few, she was hesitant on a few around the back of the court. I don't think her movement was very good. I'm very impressed with Yap's movement and her power. And these two are great when it's the attack, but when it's softer shots and just blocks in front of them. You can see Lim just, I want her to be a bit more dynamic around that court. She's very static, very strong in her base. But the other two, Anseli and Tio, I think they should be really buoyed up from the fact they did that comeback. That's really hard to come back from 15-7 down to just lose 21-17. So they're going to be, they should be confident, but also it can be really frustrating because, like, why do we let such a lead go? It was a bit of Tio's nerves, but hopefully, like I say, Anthony can be there for her, encourage her, say, right, forget that. It's all about the second game now.
Yeah, she has to talk to her a lot as she's doing now because Tio, for me, has been marginally the weakest player on the court. You can see here, even with her demeanour and her body language, she just looks a little bit tight, doesn't she?
Yeah.
We had a swing and a miss at the end of that game. And, you know, she's just got to be more dynamic, more energised. And it's almost like the confidence will come, you'd imagine, when she just puts herself out there a bit more, gets a bit bigger on the court, right?
She did that really well at the front of the court. So if we can get, if the pair can get that formation as soon as possible, get her with that serve, return, third shot, she did that very, very well. Use that again, use that to their advantage, and hopefully, yeah, the confidence will come, you know, storming through.
It's almost like act as if, isn't it? Get big out there and really throw yourself around, make your presence felt. So start of the second game then.
Service over, one love.
Good play there from Anseli.
Too long.
Better start from the off here in this game for these two. Just what the doctor ordered.
Service over. One,
yes, two. Back to basics. These are simple shots. She just needs to get that over. Keep her feet moving. Was lucky there.
Three.
Yep, was ready for her forehand, that lefty forehand. She was knew exactly where that smash was going.
Like the idea, not the execution.
Service over. Two, three.
Yep. Right idea, bring that shuttle across, get the pair confused, who's going to take it.
Well, fortune favours the brave there. It's a good close on the return.
Four, two.
Tio's doing the right things. She's going for the right shots. The execution is not coming off, but I think it's important for her to keep going for it, keep being positive and trying this. It will come, but it's easy for your head to drop.
Just that blip of self-doubt, isn't it? Just a little seed that at this highest level just gets exposed. And she's looked the least convincing player at the moment. But like you say, she's trying everything. She's wrestling with the internal demons as we speak, you feel. Well done.
Service over. 5-4.
I'd much prefer to play with someone who's positive and keeps going and keeps trying it than someone who just plays safe. And for me, that's, if you can keep it going, it will come off. Mm.
Super play from all four players. Another engaging rally.
Yeah, these rallies are going on for a minute at a time now. And they're very intense rallies. The longer they go on, the girls get tired. Still got to be able to move around that court, hit those shots in the right places. And you can just see the errors just start creeping in.
Service over, 6-0.
And a roar psychologically from young Yap in blue there at the end of that point, almost as if to get in the face of their opponents.
Play.
Oh.
Service over, 7-0.
Things have certainly come easier for the blue team than their opponents so far today. But that return, that serve error won't help.
Oh!
Service over, 8-7.
To unravel nine, for the 19-year-old Theo.
Yeah.
I hate to say it, but it's the truth. And you kind of have a sympathy for her at this stage, don't you? Because on a big sort of court and a big arena like this, there's nowhere to hide. Maybe a spotlight on them all as well. Played. Good disguise and deception there off the backhand from the youngster. I guess, Gail, it's about reducing the margin, isn't it? Playing less close to lines, clearing the net by a little more, and just as you said earlier, going back to basics.
Yeah, back to basics and just being really, really determined. The worst thing you can do is say to yourself, don't make a mistake, because then you're thinking of a negative. You're thinking of the mistake and don't do it. So the most important thing is to think of what you're good at. So, right, move your feet, shuttle over, and think in a positive frame of mind. And when you think like that, it's so much better going than, oh, just don't make a mistake, just don't make a mistake. But unfortunately, it's easier to say that than when you're in that situation and it's the final, and all you can think is, oh no, I've just hit four mistakes. They're all picking on me. It's very, very hard.
Go!
11-8 interval.
So it's a three-point lead in favour of Lim and Yap. Having taken the opening game, they look in a commanding position now in the second game as well. It's been a tighter, contested game so far. You never know, it might still go the distance, but most of the traffic has been directed towards young Theo. Anseli started to make a couple of mistakes as well. But these two playing some fine badminton.
They haven't really done much in this second set. In the first set, I was really impressed with the angles from Yap. the defence from Lim. But then there were also a few weaknesses that started showing up in the second half of the first game. But Anseli and Thiago just haven't managed to carry that on and keep the finding those gaps like they were and when they got right back into the first game. So it's got a bit easy for Lim and Yap at the moment. If Anseli and Thiago are going to have to, are they going to win this second game? They've really got to go back. I'm just sort of remember what they did in that second half, that first set.
She's trying her heart out. 13, almost over trying.
Yeah.
We've all been there.
She's not even looking at Anseli either. She's just zoned out.
What Anseli does well, Gail, sorry to intrude, is that she kind of takes her time and slows things down just to collect her thoughts.
She's been in that situation before. I've been in this situation before, and Anseli will know as well that exactly how Tia's feeling, and she'll just be like, you know what, we've all been there. Don't worry about it. Just try and enjoy it.
The Blues setting sail for home now, you feel.
Service over.
Well taken. That'll keep them afloat, the orange and blacks.
16.
Still a lot of work to do.
Anseli, she felt the need to do something special. You're way down. The pressure was on.
Brilliant play.
Really good quality of shots. Every 18, shot there was fantastic. 10. Really good women's doubles rally. And then you just have to wait. It's that patience of waiting for your chance. Ladies doubles now is everyone's so good in defense. Everyone's so good in attack. You just have to wait.
Yeah. Precision badminton from both teams there.
11-18.
And it's good to see that Anseli and Thiaux are still fighting. Yes. Yeah, they are very far down in this match, and it would be very easy for them to just not give up, but just not play at 100%. But they're not, and they're still going for it, which is really, really good to see. I really wanted
her to run down and give her a hug.
Me too. I really wanted her to get that shot, but she just had no confidence whatsoever.
A guttural roar of approval then from Lim and Yap as they close in.
Match point 12.
8 championship points.
Bolt. Service over. 13-20. Play.
Firing on all cylinders throughout then. It's Yin Lu Lim and Yap Cheng Won. 21-17, 21-13. They take the title and show their joy. 38 minutes played. What a watchable contest that was. And for the other team, well, they'll chalk that one down to experience, Anseli and Thiaux. But certainly Lim and Yap being marginally better throughout. A good experience for all four players, young and old. The Malaysian badminton very much on the up.